الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي جعلنا من أمة خير الخلق على الإطلاق سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك على حبيبنا الكريم شفيعنا وقرة أعيننا نور قلوبنا سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد فيا عباد الله أوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله العظيم My dear brothers in Islam, I remind myself and all of us here today that we should always strive to increase our taqwa to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to obey all that has been ordained upon us as Muslims, to obey the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to stay away from all that has been prohibited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers, taqwa is not just by saying the word taqwa. We do not gain taqwa by listening advice to have taqwa, but we gain taqwa by striving to increase our deeds, by striving to stay away from all sins and to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers in Islam, Islam is a complete religion. It encompasses all our actions in our daily lives. It encompasses our interactions. It gives us guidelines how to have interactions. It gives us guidelines to go about our daily lives in obtaining the rida, the pleasure, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it also encompasses our virtual interactions. What I mean and what this khutbah is saying about our interaction on the internet. My dear brothers, in today's world, it is a fact that we cannot avoid communicating in the virtual world. In fact, technology today has enabled us to interact while being on the move through the use of mobile gadgets without being hooked up to a personal computer. However, in our excitement to leverage on technology, we should not be obsessed with social media platforms to the point that it may adversely affect our interaction and communication with family members. We should not be so attached to our mobile gadgets that we are inseparable from our mobile devices when we are eating, drinking, sitting with our family members. It has become one of the biggest distractions in our daily lives, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always reminds us, and we are always reminded to always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to always be in remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to always remember the teachings of Islam, to always praise and send our salam and salawat to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But maybe some of us, or most of us, find ourselves always looking at our handphones. Even some of us, even listening to this khutbah, still are looking at our handphones. We are not remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are disobeying what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches us to do. We are so far from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, let alone without our devices. We are always having difficulty to rectify ourselves. We always have difficulty to always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to always strive to follow the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then how about with our handphones and all our devices? We are distracted so much more. And so here are just some guidelines or teachings of Islam that we must take note of. Firstly, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Khaliqin nasa bi khuluqin hasanin," which means engage others with good character. But sadly, we find our brothers, we find fellow Muslims and Muslimas always giving disparaging remarks, always belittling others, always talking bad about our brothers in Islam. Just imagine if our brother that we are disparaging on the internet, if we are in front of him, would we say the same words? So this shows how our faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sadly also, we have some brothers who are a bit irresponsible, giving disparaging remarks, not just for our brothers, but also towards our ulama, towards our scholars. Some of us dare say and accuse that our scholars are corrupt and our scholars do not have a stand in Islam. They do not understand Islam. But only they know Islam better than our scholars. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, reminds us, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, O people of faith, Allah is addressing us. Ijtanibu kathiran minal dhan, inna ba'da dhan ithm. O you who believe, avoid much negative assumption. Indeed, inna ba'da dhan ithm, some assumption is sin. Wala tajassasu, and do not spy on each other. وَلَا يَغْتَبْ بَعْضُكُمْ بَعْضًا. Do not backbite each other or speak ill about our brother. أَيُحِبُّ أَحَدُكُمْ. Would one of you like to eat? أَنْ يَأْكُلَ لَحْمَ أَخِيهِ. The flesh of his brother, مَيْتَ. When he is dead. فَكَرِهْتُمُ. You would definitely detest it. And fear Allah. وَاتَّقُ اللَّهِ. إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. And fear Allah, have taqwa in Allah. Verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is accepting of our tawbah, is accepting of our repentance. Yeah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Rahim, the most merciful towards us. So we look at this ayah. At the end of this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us to have taqwa. Taqwa in everything that we do. So one of the meanings of taqwa is always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and stay away from the sins, especially in this verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly, specifically mentioned the vices, the sins, which is to spy on each other, to find our mistakes, to find faults with each other, where Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam teaches us to always cover up for our brothers, to always cover the faults of our brothers. When we do not even look at our own faults, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us and cover all our faults.
Amen.
And then, another reason some of us lose ourselves on the internet is the perception that we do not have accountability. We always forget that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows everything that we do. We forget that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching every little thing that we do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us, Allah knows everything. يَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةَ الْعَيُّنُ وَمَا تُخْفِ الصُّدُورِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the betrayal of our eyes. Allah knows when we are looking at things that are haram, even people do not know. وَمَا تُخْفِ الصُّدُورِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what is covered inside our hearts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows our hearts, what is inside our hearts, what is the content of our hearts, what more what we post on the internet, what more our actions on the internet. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hold us accountable for everything that we do, even with our fingers. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam also reminds us in a hadith which means, whoever calls upon others to deviant practices, then he will bear the sins of those who followed him, and it does not reduce the sin and the sins of those who follows him. Just look at how Allah Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam emphasized the largeness of our sins. For let's say we talk bad about a person, we say something upon him, unto him, that he did not do. We spread fitnah about a person. And then that person, another one who looks at our status, he shares our status, he shares the fitnah. And then another person who looks at the status, shares that status and shares the fitnah until it spreads spreads like wildfire, and so your sins will spread like wildfire. Everything you are, everything you do is accountable by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another thing that we have to take note of, to always be vigilant to everything that we share. We do not simply look at some information and believe it to be true, and then we share it to others. That will cause us to stray away from the teachings of Islam, because we do not know. There's no way for us to verify. For example, there are some fatwas going around. The so-called scholar is sharing a hukum, a peculiar ruling in Islam, and then we do not even know whether it is true or not, and then we share with another person. Please, brothers, be vigilant about what we share. We do not know who is really saying that. People can just add to a quote, and this is said by so by so, this is said by so and so, this is said by so and so. How do we verify that? So what we cannot verify, please stay away from showing that and sharing that to others. And lastly, one more thing, always be vigilant to what we share on Facebook, especially our aurat, especially the aurat of our sisters, especially the aurat of our wife, especially the aurat of our family. Some of us share the photos of their family members where their aurat is disclosed. Some of us share the aurat of our sisters and his own wife and his own family. Share this to others. We do not like to show ourselves when we are not properly covered to others. But we show our families to everyone, even to those who do not know us, when we are not covered. Be vigilant, because by doing that, we are also spreading the sins of our own self. There's needlessly, we share things that we do not share. And also, beware of being narcissistic. Some of us like to share photos ourselves and also like to collect likes, like to be praised by people. Look at the example of our pious predecessors. Some of them, when praised, they throw sand at those who praise them because they do not like to be praised. Being praised can spoil our hearts. Liking to be praised spoils our hearts. Make us like ourselves, where Islam teaches us to always everything attribute it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The beauty, if it is in us, attribute it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We do not attain it. We do not do it by ourselves. It is all a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So always be thankful towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be careful of praising someone, and also when we are being praised. We must also be extra vigilant in ensuring that our children, especially the young, do not fall prey to irresponsible people who use these social media websites to trap innocent children. These days, many young children who are still in primary school already have their own Facebook accounts and others. It is an unhealthy trend. And while that is worrying, it actually allows irresponsible individuals with bad intentions to take advantage of children, be it girls and boys. And also, we must always remind ourselves and our brothers and also our teen and also our youth. The internet has made it so easy for us and for them and for sick people to obtain and have access to pornography, let alone the distractions of the virtual world, let alone the distractions of the handphone and everything and each one of our gadgets. What more, the sins and the additional sins that we gain from using our mobile phones. It is a tool. Everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us is a tool for us to increase the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our mobile gadgets is a tool to communicate with each other. Look at it also as a tool to increase our taqwa in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Use it for good. Share the verses from the Quran. Listen to the hadith. Listen to talks by ulama, by scholars. Fill our time with things that are beneficial to us and also our family members. Remember that it is a tool that we can use to bring us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not use it to make us look like fools in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hopefully, by always being mindful of our ethics, we are people from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We are people from the ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the person, the being with the highest level of akhlaq, with the highest ethical behavior, but we do not reflect that. We are the people of Ummat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We do not have ethics, we do not have adab, we do not have akhlaq in the internet. So remind ourselves and also our brothers and sisters that we are the ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That should be reflected in everything that we do in our daily interactions, be it in this world and also in the virtual world. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us and grant us the strength to follow the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to follow the akhlaq of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and more importantly to follow in the guidance of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah give us the strength to abstain and stay away from all that causes the displeasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this life and also in the hereafter. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us and our families from the fitnah of this world, Ameen. And also the fitnah of Qabr, and also the fitnah of Masih Dajjal, and also the fitnah of Akhirah. Amin ya Rabbal Alamin. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim, wa rafa'ani wa iyaakum bima fihi min al-ayati wa dhikri al-Hakim, wa taqabbala minni wa minkum tilawatahu innahu huwa sami'ul alim. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah al-Azim li wa lakum, wa lisairil muslimina wal muslimat, wal mu'minina wal mu'minat, fa astaghfiruhu fa ya fawzal mustaghfirin, wa ya najatat ta'ibin.
اللهم صل وسلم وزد وأدم وأنعم وتفضل وبارك بجلالك وكمالك على زين عبادك وأشرف عبادك سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. ورضي الله تبارك وتعالى عن كل الصحابة أجمعين. اللهم انت رب لن تخلو سبحانك نستغفرك وتوب الى
الله. الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي ارسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون. اشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم على حبيبنا العظيم شفيعنا قرة اعيننا نور قلوبنا شفيعنا سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد فيا أيها الإخوان اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Saudara-saudaraku sekalian, bertakwalah kamu kepada Allah Subhanahu wa taala dan janganlah kamu mati melainkan kamu berada di dalam keadaan Islam. Kesimpulan daripada khutbah yang telah disampaikan pada awal tadi adalah supaya kita bertakwa kepada Allah Subhanahu wa taala, melaksanakan kewajipan-kewajipan kita, taat perintah Allah, jauhkan diri daripada segala yang dilarang oleh Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Perintah Allah dan larangannya merangkumi setiap aspek di dalam kehidupan kita, sama ada di dalam perhubungan dan pergaulan kita di dalam dunia kita ataupun di dalam dunia internet, di Facebook dan di sebagainya. Islam mengajar kita akhlak, ikutlah akhlak Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam di dalam kita bergaul dan berhubung di dalam internet dan sebagainya. Lihatlah beberapa contoh pada hari ini, ada di kalangan kita yang suka mengutuk antara satu dengan yang lain, suka menghukum antara satu dengan yang lain, suka memburuk kan antara kita sesama Islam. Malah ada di kalangan kita yang mengutuk di kalangan para ulama dan juga mufti kita dan mengatakan mereka adalah orang-orang yang tidak bertanggungjawab, mereka adalah orang-orang yang tidak mentaati Allah Subhanahu wa taala, mereka orang-orang yang membesarkan dunia dan lain-lainnya daripada Allah Subhanahu wa taala. Ini sangat jauh dengan akhlak Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Maka panduan Islam mengajar kita, ia merangkumi setiap aspek kehidupan kita. Akhlak yang mulia bukan sahaja di luar, bukan sahaja di hadapan orang-orang yang kita muliakan. Akhlak yang mulia di dalam setiap pergaulan kita, setiap perbualan kita, setiap perhubungan kita. Ingatlah bahawa setiap yang kita lakukan dipertanggungjawabkan oleh Allah Subhanahu wa taala. Setiap fitnah yang kita kongsi di internet dipertanggungjawabkan oleh Allah Subhanahu wa taala. Malah Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mengingatkan kita membawa kepada keburukan, Maksud daripada hadis itu, kita membawa kepada keburukan, dan orang yang mengikut keburukan kita, dan selepas itu orang lain mengikuti keburukan kita, maka kita dapat pahala, kita dapat ganjaran dosa bagi setiap yang disebarkan itu dan seterusnya. Bertakwalah kepada Allah Subhanahu wa taala, ikutlah panduan Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, gambarkanlah kemuliaan kita ini sebagai umat Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam di dalam setiap yang kita lakukan di dalam kehidupan kita. Amin ya rabbal alamin. Ala sallu wa sallimu ala nabi mustafa khairil anam, haitsu qala Allah taala fi kitabih, innallaha wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'alan nabi, ya ayyuhalladzina amanu sallu 'alaihi wa sallimu taslima.
Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik 'alaihi.
Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala ali sayyidina Muhammad kama sallaita ala sayyidina Ibrahim wa ala ali sayyidina Ibrahim, wa barik ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala ali sayyidina Muhammad kama barakta ala sayyidina Ibrahim wa ala ali sayyidina Ibrahim fil alamin innaka Hamidum Majid. Waridallahumma 'anil khulafa'i ar-rashidin sayyidatina Abi Bakr wa Umar wa Uthman wa Ali
radiyallahu anhum,
radiyallahu anhum wa an baqiyati as-sahabati wal qarabati wat tabi'in wa tabi'at tabi'in wa tabi'ihim bi ihsanin ila yaumiddin. Allahummaghfir lil muslimina wal muslimat wal mu'minina wal mu'minat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka sami'un qaribun mujibud da'awat wa qadil hajat ya Allah ya sami'a du'a'il muslimin. Allahummaghfir lana dhunubana wa liwalidina warhamhum kama rabbawna sighara, waghfir li asatidatina wa li mashayikhina wa li muallimina ajma'in. Rabbana atina fid dunya hasanah wa fil akhirati hasanah wa qina adhaban nar. Allahumma a'izz al-islam wal muslimin. Allahumma a'izz al-islam wal muslimin. Allahumma a'izz al-islam wal muslimin wa adhill ash-shirka wal mushrikin wal mu'tadin wal athimin wal zalimin. Ibadallah, إن الله يأمركم بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم واسألوه من فضله يعطيكم. ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. بسم الله.